So Rachel, we've pulled up on a bar here near the end of the Swinomish Channel because we found some Spartina grass here. What do we got?
Well, I've got a couple samples of Spartina here. This one is showing us really nicely the super classic Spartina growth pattern. Now it's a grass, first of all, so we see the central stem with the leaves coming off at kind of this regular pattern.
Uh-huh.
And on Spartina, this 45 to 90 degree angle of the leaf is really indicative, so you can see that really well. And you'll notice the leaves tend to be kind of short compared to some of our other grasses, and they're really, really pokey at the end. They come to a really stiff point. And you can see this stuff doesn't blow in the wind a whole lot, does it?
Does that help you identify it when you're paddling by?
Yeah, it can. It's kind of a stiff, upright plant. It's not like, if you want to take a look, here's some of the native dune grass in the background here. See how that's waving really gently in the wind? So sometimes that can help you identify it, is just to notice how stiff and strong it is. And there's also some right next to my boat right here that's flowering. And you can see those seed heads presenting that very classic kind of feathery Spartina flower. And once these seeds drop, it'll start to look a little more like this one, a little bit more just kind of like a regular grass seed head that's dried out.
Now what happens with those seeds?
Well, these seeds will fall into the water, and one of the characteristics of Puget Sound is lots and lots of current swirling around. So this current has helped to distribute these seeds from that original infestation site in Stanwood to really, it's starting to get all over the Salish Sea.
Now, once you have a hold of it and you have something that you think is Spartina, how can you be sure that it is?
Well, one thing that you can do to verify it, if you can actually get the plant in your hands like this, is to look at what's called the ligule. The ligule on a grass is the place, the joint, kind of where the leaf meets the stem of the plant. And on Spartina, if you carefully separate this, and I'll kind of hold this up in profile, Liam, so hopefully you can see it. There's the ligule on Spartina, kind of looks like hairy eyelashes. They call it a hairy ligule, actually, and that's an authentic scientific term. So you can separate that ligule and see those hairs in profile, and that can tell you that this is a Spartina species. If you see something that you think might be Spartina, one person that you can contact locally is your county noxious weed coordinator. Pretty much every county has a noxious weed control board, and they're responsible for overseeing that Spartina control. And you can take a digital photo or some other way of identifying, or even grab a sample and stick it in a bag and send it away.